Yesterday we discussed the thing, everything which complete our needs. What are these things? See, student, pay attention. I am going to be discuss very interesting lecture and very interesting topic. The things, that these are the things which are gifted by the nature. Air, water, environment, mountain, river, oceans. These are very important things which gifted by the nature. They complete our needs. But what happened? Nowadays, human beings create such problems in which, on the name of the development, they exploited the resources. And these are the gifted by the nature. But human beings exploited the resources on the basis of development, indiscriminate development. And we want the development should be in a sustainable, not unsustainable. The development should be sustainable. The sustainable development helps for the future. But human beings and some countries, they create the problems. What are these problems? Firstly, we discuss number first thing, depletion of the resources. Depletion of the resources for satisfying the greedy humans. That is the problem. Satisfying the greedy humans, that will not satisfy and it creates the problem for the development. The second one is accumulation of the resources. The accumulation of resources are in such hand and it creates the problem. It creates the problem for the equality among the peoples. And if the resources are accumulated in few hands, then it creates the problem. What is the problem? It creates the gap between rich and poor. And when the gap is going to be increased, it also creates the problems. The third thing is indiscriminate exploitation. Exploitation of the resources. Exploitation of the resources of few countries. See what happened? Exploitation of the resources. The few nations and the few peoples, they create the problem. For an example, the few nations, America, England, France, they are just exploiting our natural resources, the air, the water. What happened? After some time, what happened? It creates the problem. The air is going to be polluted. And then what happened? The common peoples and the underdeveloping countries, they are facing big problems. The developed nations, they are just developing the different types. Or they are just earning a lot of money for emission of the carbon. They set up number of industries. They cut down forests. But we students, we didn't want that development should be going on indiscriminately. We want the development should be going on in a sustainable way. Sustainable development. We give the development, such type of the development for our future generation. So the future generation, they enjoy that, what the development our ancestors give. And we cannot discriminate and create, pollute the natural resources. So we want sustainable development. So what is sustainable development? I am going to be explaining it. We want sustainable development. Okay. Sustainable development. What is the meaning of the sustainable development? The development should be going on. The development should be going on without damaging the environment. Without damaging the environment. We want development, but such type of the development which helps the environment, not damage the environment. Suppose that we government want to set up a national highway. It's good. Government set up the national highway. And if the trees are just coming, they just cut down. But we set up some, we plant some more trees near by the national highway. Or we set up some green belts. So it helps for the development. It helps for the purifying of air, of natural resources. That is very important. Regarding the sustainable development, I am just giving an example. Example of the Rio de Janeiro. There was an Earth Summit in 1992. The Earth Summit 1992 at Rio de Janeiro and in Brazil. In Brazil, the Earth Summit. It was the first Earth Summit. And in this first Earth Summit, 100 head of the nations, different part of the world, they just joined the first Earth Summit. What was the agenda of the first Earth Summit? That they want discuss about the sustainable development. They focus the indiscriminate development process is going on European continent, American continent. They want to focus that how much the problems it create for the future generation. And the development just going on indiscriminately, completely indiscriminate. So that was the first summit, first Earth Summit at Rio de Janeiro in Brazil in 1992, 3rd to 14th June. So 100 of the head of the nation, they also put their signature on the climate actions, and they decided that they cut down their emissions, carbon emission in nature, because they give the chance to the underdeveloping nations. And they also focus on agenda 21. What was the agenda 21? The agenda 21 basically regarding the sustainable development. Basically regarding the sustainable development. It is also called UNCED, United Nations Conference on Environmental and Development. The other name, suppose that the examiner, they want to check, you will write the full form of UNCED, United Nations Conference on Environment and Development. See, environment and development, the other name, that is the Earth Summit of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil in 1992. They also focus on the different thing on agenda, combat environment damage, poverty, disease, such type of the disease. They also causes the causes of the such type of the disease, that is emission of carbon, impurity of air, impurity of water. If we just cut down more and more trees, it means definitely the problems, global warming. See the problems nowadays, the indiscriminate development. America wants the more and more on GDP. Same thing the France, England. What happened? The global warming, the problem of the global warming nowadays we are facing. And why the global warming? Because only and only the development of the increasing of the GDP of such developed nations. They are on the name of the development. And the problem faces by the underdeveloping nations. See what happened nowadays? See, we are facing the problem of the global warming in India also. In some areas during the monsoon season, in some areas we have seen the floods, and in some part of the nations the drought is there. We want sustainable development. That's why in 1992 the Earth Summit was held in the month of June, 3rd to 14th June. The agenda was they want to combat and they discuss the problem regarding the degradation of environment. And in that part, one of the agency of the UN, UNCED, United Nations Conference on Environment and Development, they want that they discuss about the development of environmental problems. Students, these things are very important. We did not want such type of the environment which create the problem present as well as in future. Because the environment, because these resources are gifted by the nature, whatever we got from the ancestors, it's our duty that we give pure air, pure water, pure river, we should give to our future generation. That is very important. Okay. And we also do the Agenda 21 regarding the on the local level. You also do on the local level, planted more and more trees, aware the peoples in your society, aware in the local government. You discuss the suppose that if you lived in village or you got the chance to visit in any village, you just meet the head of the village and discuss that, sir, what are you doing for the upgradation of environment? What are your plannings? You just discuss in your society. We government celebrated one monsoon during the time of the rainy season. We just planted the trees. So that is the duty. The environment, it is not the chapter that we discuss on the board and the notebooks. We just discuss on practical level. Okay, Agenda 21 helps that the people, the students or the government work on the local level, like panchayat, district level, community level. Okay, so once again, UNCED, the UNCED, United Nations Conference on Environment and Development. Okay, next we discuss regarding the resources, the planning of the resources. That is very important. Planning, resources planning, okay. Planning of the resources. Planning of resources. How we plan the resources? It is very important. It is very important, planning of the resources. How we plan? Planning is widely accepted strategy for judicious use of resources. Because government must be aware with the help of education. We use the resources according, make the strategy for judicious. That is very important. It has the importance like the country India, because we have the availability of resources in a diversification. Suppose that in Madhya Pradesh, in the central part of India, in Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, see, Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh or some other states have abundant resources are there. But what happened in Rajasthan, what happened in Haryana, what happened in southern part of other states, we have such type of the resources are not found, like coal, iron, bauxite, some other resources. These resources are not found. These are found basically in Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh. So we want the development should be in a sustainable way. So that's why we make the planning for the resources. See, I have just given an example of Arunachal Pradesh. What happened in Arunachal Pradesh? There is abundant amount of water is there, but no infrastructure development in Arunachal Pradesh. And in Rajasthan, what happened? There is no water. But in Arunachal Pradesh, there is a huge amount of abundant water is there, but the infrastructure is not there. See, in Rajasthan, the water is not there, but we have the land resources in abundant form. So, without water, that land resources not used properly. That's why we make such type of the things that help in the development. The same other example, we just take Ladakh, upper part of Jammu and Kashmir, presently Union Territory of India. Okay, after 2019, it is the UT of India. What happened in Ladakh? Ladakh is, the maximum part of the Ladakh is covered in cold desert. But the scarcity of water is there. Ladakh is rich in their cultural heritage. But the development, infrastructure development was negligible, nothing. So we set up such type of the development in that area, like western part of Rajasthan, in Ladakh, in Arunachal Pradesh. We maintain the sustainable, we maintain the equality. We set up such type of the institutions in Ladakh, in Rajasthan, in Arunachal Pradesh, so the people enjoy the different resources. That is very important. That's why we make the planning. What the planning in India, firstly we want to identify the resources. How we identify the resources? Identify कीजिए, आपके पास कहाँ-कहाँ resources हैं, how many resources you have there? Identification of resources. Identify कीजिए how much resources you have, how much and where it is. See, in the beginning of the chapter, I discuss everything found in the nature that complete our needs. So we require each and everything. So firstly, we want to identify where, how much iron ore we have, how much bauxite we have, how much coal we have. Firstly, we identify. Then we invent. We start the invent process, the technology. We want modern technology so that we can save the resources. That is very important. Firstly, we identify. Second, we invent the resources. That how much resources we have with the help of technology. With the help of mapping, we just give the mapping ki how much the resources in which part of India. Okay, that is very important. Second one is employing a planning structure, appropriate technology. We give the appropriate technology and we set up some skill institutions like IIT. The student of IIT, they just find out the alternate of fossil fuels. Now what happened in India? The Indian government set up, we know that the Indian Railway play a very important role. Okay, we know that the crude oil, one day the diesel or the crude oil is just finished, then how can we run the Indian Railway? We find out some alternates. For example, we set up the railway lines Bombay to Pune and from Delhi to Agra, or Delhi to Jaipur to Mumbai. So we set up electric engine, the alternate of diesel. Okay, the alternate of diesel. So that is the very important thing. The next last one is that matching the resources development plans with overall national development plans. We just match. Ki what the plan we are going to be. That plan should be matched with the national development plan. That is very important. We want sustainable. The development should not be centralized in Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata or Bangalore. The development should be in the different part of India. That is very important. It should be the same development that is in Bangalore IT. We set up the IT sector that is in northern part of Jammu and Kashmir. We also set up some IT industry in Uttar Pradesh, in northeastern part of India. So people enjoy all the resources in their native place. And we also understand that the development is sustainable, not indiscriminate. Equality. We give the equality of each and every place. That is very, very important. So I am just giving the activity, prepare a list of the resources found in your state. You have to be prepare a list that what resources are found in Haryana. For an example, in Haryana, we just found resources, the natural resources, what? Alluvial soil. So you just find out what type of the resources found in Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, West Bengal, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Bombay, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Rajasthan. You just make the list of the different state, what type of the resources in different state are found. And you also write a note that is the development in a sustainable, equality way or indiscriminately. So I am just going to discuss. It's very important. It's a question, moral based questions. Sometimes examiner asks moral based questions. 3 marks or 4 marks. 4 marks, 4 point. 5 marks, 5 point. You just explain in your own ideas. And I will discuss. The last one is the find out the other activity. Find out resources are being developed in your surrounding by the community, village, panchayat. You also find out the resources. Suppose that in your community you have the resources, the community people develop that resources or not. If you lived in village, so ask the village panchayat, the village head of the village panchayat, develop the resources or not. It's very okay.